Okay, I guess I'll talk about the oddity, yeah, and in retrospect and reflect. I don't know, I probably do get that word wrong a lot, that last word I was saying, perspective of perception versus perspective. I think I interchange them wrong, but yeah, I wanted to talk about, because I was going on and on about photography, about, oh, my photos are missing, they're missing, I don't have them anymore, I can't remake them, and so it's such a devastation. And so I'm going back and in reflect, I'm like, why is it such a devastation? You know, why is it such a devastation to me to lose that time frame? That particular group of photos. I mean, they're just photos of plants, you know. In yes, maybe places that are difficult to go to again, you know. But they're replaceable, you know, as a photo event, you know. If you look at it that way, you know, that tactile, logical, assumption. They're replaceable that way, but I'm like, no. There's this certain energy to them. There's a certain energy to them that is not replaceable. And so I'm like, okay, how? Why was that energy so high? You know, was a high compounding energy. And I'm looking back, and you know, just like the pages in your mind. You know, I'm looking back. I'm going, well, I had the dogs. You know, I had my three dogs. You know, just outstanding animals, and they were just there in my life. Okay, so I had the three dogs. I had the stability of my husband. All right, so I had the stability, and I had the three dogs. I had the essential freedom to just live in expoundant love with no limits. I had that freedom. So, when I'm looking here, I'm looking at a flower right now, and I'm just like, I just don't want to even take its picture. I just don't feel that kind of expoundant love coming from myself any longer. You know, when those things have been taken away from you, all of them, the three dogs, my husband, they're all been taken away. It's extremely difficult to find that expoundant love again, because every photo I took, when I look back into it, when I look into it, like seriously look into it, I am in a love experience. There was love going on in my life every day when I woke up, every day when I went to sleep, 3 o'clock in the morning, 4 o'clock in the morning, there was love in my life every minute, every second. It was never gone. So I had that in my photos. They were in each photo I took of each little plant, each little flower, each little bee, or whatever, a butterfly that went by. I had all of that huge love capacity there. All right, so time goes by, and yes, and the ducks also, the ducks and the chickens, all of them, love, all love events for me. Do you understand? They're all love events. So even when my maestro husband had to go off to work, He went off to work, you know, and he just left me there at the house. Even when that was going on, I still felt love. Do you understand? I was still in the capacity feeling of love. I still had my animals. And I really believe they have a swelter of give. And you can say, well, you just feed them. You just feed them. Well, as time goes on after all the food, there is something else that just starts to beam out from that animal. Whether it is a light, I mean, it could actually be a light. And I'm like, well, there was such a good light. I cannot seem to replace that light. I can't just look into the camera and have that same light any longer. Maybe that light was actually from those animals. Maybe that light was from my husband. Maybe that light was from all of that. That culmination. So maybe together that created a beautiful love. Do you understand? So when I'm looking like, where am I going to take photographs? It's just a mute, dead report at this point. I don't have animals in that same situation, or any situation, really. You know, there's the occasional cat that may walk by, that moans for food, and maybe becomes my friend extra. And maybe I do start to see a little bit of rainbow extra, whether it's the dependency rainbow, the security rainbow. We're having a security rainbow with the animal and the human. It could very well be a security rainbow. But we're having that, you know, little by little, if I start to give food. That is true. But it is so small in comparison to what I had before. It is so small. So yeah, so when I'm looking into like, gee, you know, I'll just, you know, live in that logical, I will just go and replace them. I will go take pictures over there or over there. Oh my God, wouldn't that be something? But it's not possible because of those sequentials that were in the mix. Do you understand? So I'm really believing light, and whether it's a light they gave me and that bounced off me and vice versa, a light we felt some kind of a halo that it gave me or a respect to my aura, something. If it is something in that expound, maybe that's why. And maybe they weren't the most perfect pictures. That's not the point. But they're pictures that I can make extremely beautiful. And so they've given me just an incredible capacity. Whereas right now, if I'm just like, well, there's over there like this, I start to feel like that, what do you call it, that Borg. That person that is just a dry heave of nothing. Just a dry heave of a nothing event. Oh, there is a flower, you know. And there's nothing else offered. There's nothing else offered. And I really believe that the else offered is a love light that is coming from you. It's coming from your events in your life. So my love light is really dim at the moment. It's almost out.